In the saga of misinformation on social media, hundreds of Facebook pages run political propaganda on a daily basis. But have you ever wondered who are these people that run these pages that have millions of followers? Alt News investigated the inner workings of one such Facebook page, The India Eye, that has 17 lakh followers and its posts are liked and shared by thousands on a daily basis. All the content that goes on the India Eye Facebook page is similarly worded and designed. What you see is a well-made poster that has the India Eye logo and a few lines of text. The narrative that the page predominantly uses is praises for the central government, criticism of opposition parties, and attacks on the liberal minds in the society. The India Eye Facebook page is essentially a factory of misinformation. Last year, when Ravish Kumar spoke about the gruesome murder of Gauri Lankesh, his video was clipped and put in a manner that presented the journalist as speaking on behalf of a political party. Earlier this month, this page shared a poster that claimed that members of the opposition party vandalized the school bus of Sanskriti School in Pune during the Bharat Band. However, when Alt News spoke to the trustees of the school, they told us that the school bus was vandalized the previous day and had nothing to do with the Bharat Band. In yet another instance, they claimed that India has taken no loans from the World Bank during 2015-17. However, Alt News found that we did take loans for 50 projects during that period of time to the tune of over $96,000. There are several such examples of fake news posted by the India Eye Facebook page that Alt News identified. And looking at the propensity and regularity of the misleading information that they propagate, Alt News decided to dig deeper.
While trying to determine as to who are the individuals behind this India Eye Facebook page, on the About section of the India Eye Facebook page, the domain name of this Facebook page was listed as the indiaeye.com. And there was a phone number also which was listed, which was 85869930 60. Now we first looked at the phone number, we searched the phone number on Twitter, and we came across several tweets where this phone number was being promoted as the WhatsApp number of the India Eye Facebook page. Among all the tweets, a large majority of the tweets were by a handle called Heman Namo. Now this handle neither had a personal profile picture nor a proper name. The profile picture was that of Mr. Narendra Modi, while the name was Heman Namo. So it was not possible to determine who this person was by just looking at the Twitter profile. However, when we looked through the old tweets of this Twitter handle, we found one tweet in which this person had put out a personal profile picture. When we reverse searched that picture, we came across the company website of one company called Silver Touch Technologies, where in the About section of the website, this person's photo was there, and next to it, he was being described as the full-time director of the company, and his name was Mr. Himanshu Jain. Next, we looked at the domain name that was listed in the About section of the India Eye Facebook page, that is theindiaeye.com. Now, what we found was that the IP address that this domain name resolved to, which is 50.23.93.64, this IP address belonged to a group of IP addresses which was owned by the Silver Touch company itself. This indicated that the India Eye website was hosted on the Silver Touch company servers and that the company was giving infrastructural support to the India Eye website. During our research, we also found yet another domain name called theindiaeye.in. Now, to remind our viewers, the domain name that was listed on the India Eye Facebook page was theindiaeye.com. And now we found another domain name called theindiaeye.in. Now the coincidence between these two domain names was that they were registered at exactly the same time, which was Jan 24th, 2016 at 12:16 hours UTC. Now the interesting thing that we found about the indiaeye.in domain name is that it was registered to Mr. Himanshu Jain himself, and this information was available on a website called domainbigdata.com. However, this was not the only coincidence. When we were looking at the India Eye Facebook page, the info section of that Facebook page listed all the name changes that this particular Facebook page has gone through. Now, this is a new feature that Facebook has introduced in order to bring greater transparency, where they list all the name changes that a particular Facebook page goes through. So the info section of the India I Facebook page showed that it was originally called Changing India and it was eventually renamed to the India I. Now, the renaming to the India I also happened on 24 June 2016, which was the same date as the registration of the indiai.com and the indiai.in. However, this was not the only link that we found between the India I Facebook page and Mr. Himanshu Jain. While going through the old tweets of Mr. Himanshu, we found the URL to Mr. Himanshu's old Facebook account, which was facebook.com/on.himanshujain. When we clicked on this URL, we were redirected to facebook.com/theindiai. What that means is, if you take the URL, that is facebook.com/on.himanshujain, and put it in the URL bar of your browser, then this will redirect you to the Facebook page of the India I. All this evidence shows the deep association between the India I Facebook page and Mr. Himanshu Jain, who is the full-time director of Silver Touch Technologies. So what exactly does Silver Touch Technology do?
Silver Touch Technology was established in Ahmedabad in 1992. Apart from providing web IT solutions, the company also has a section on e-governance, which is described on its website as, and I quote, "We are serving citizens' needs while working on government projects for more than 2.5 decades. Our e-governance service practices include a vast array of services." Besides e-governance being a prominent business vertical of Silver Touch, the company has also provided web and IT solutions to individual politicians. For instance, in 2015, Silver Touch developed the official mobile application for Prime Minister Narendra Modi. In fact, Silver Touch has done a lot of work for the BJP government. In 2014, it developed the website for the Ministry of Culture, which was inaugurated by Shripad Nayak, who currently holds the portfolio of the Minister of State in the Ayush Ministry. That same year, Silver Touch developed the application for the President, which was inaugurated in the Rashtrapati Bhavan, and Himanshu Jain was a part of the occasion. Government projects is such an important vertical for Silver Touch that 53% of its business came from here in the year 2017. This was disclosed by Silver Touch last year to the National Stock Exchange. This wasn't the first time that Silver Touch was in news. Last year, NDTV had reported that the Gujarat government was among the top clients of Silver Touch, with 17 departments of the state government availing its services. This report also revealed that some employees of Silver Touch were involved in social media propaganda, like trending hashtags promoting the BJP. Himanshu Jain was also a part of this endeavor. When NDTV contacted Himanshu Jain in 2017, he said that his social media activities were in a personal capacity and had no link whatsoever to Silver Touch. When AltNews contacted Himanshu Jain, he reiterated the same to us, while further adding that he had no links to the Facebook page, The India I. We also contacted the managing director of Silver Touch, Mr. Vipul Thakkar, who told us that the company isn't even aware of the Facebook page, The India I. However, soon after our conversation with Himanshu Jain, the domain name theindiai.com, which was listed in the About section of its Facebook page, was removed, and the IP address of this domain name, which earlier pointed to Silver Touch servers, had also been changed. Not just that, but after our conversation with Himanshu Jain, he put out a series of angry tweets in an attempt to defend himself. However, none of his tweets were refuting the questions that were raised by AltNews. This response and the earlier knee-jerk reaction of removing the indiai.com domain name from its Facebook page and also changing the IP address of the website indicated a guilt on part of both Himanshu Jain and Silver Touch.